Hello class 9 children and welcome to today's online class. So chapter is same, that is chapter triangle, but I have come up with a new question. So let us discuss this question and try to find the solution of it. So here I have a question in the figure. So you can see here I have a figure. This figure will be given in the examination. AB is parallel to EF. This is AB and this is EF. So these two lines are parallel. AB is parallel to EF, so they are parallel. Next, AC and ED, AC and ED are also equal, and angle ACB, that means this angle ACB is equal to angle EDF, that means this angle. So these two angles also are equal, and AC is equal to ED. So this is also given. Now prove that AB is equal to FE. So you have to prove that AB is equal to FE. So these two are equal, that you have to prove. And second, BD is equal to CF. So these two things you have to prove, children. So let us start our solution. So first of all, in solution we will write the given part. So the things which are given, that we will write. So what is given? It is given that AB is parallel to EF. Okay, second, what is given? Second, AC is equal to ED. This is given. Thirdly, angle ACB is equal to angle EDF. So that is also given here. So these three things are given. And what to prove? So to prove, all you have to write in systematic way. Given part, then to prove. To prove, what is to prove? AB is equal to FE. First thing to prove. And second thing, what to prove? BD is equal to CF. So this is to prove. Now to prove these two, I will show you some proof. So to prove, and now I am going to show you proof, and then I will say hence proved. So in the proof I will write two triangles. In triangle ABC I will write first, in triangle ABC, and second one I will write triangle EDF, whatever name you can write, EDF. So in these two triangle, two things have been already given. Which are those two things given? In this two triangle, AC is equal to ED. So this AC is equal to ED. So I have given you symbol also. These two sides are equal. It is given. So it is given. In the given portion also I have written. I am repeating the same. Second, what is given? Angle ACB equal to angle EDF. It is also given in the question. ACB, this C, and EDF, this D, both are equal. It is given. Next, nothing is given, but what is given? That AB is parallel to EF. Now this is parallel. That parallel doesn't mean that something is equal, but because of this parallel, one good news we have. Now you see, AB is parallel to EF. These two are parallel. Now by this, what will happen? I will just show you one example. Suppose these two lines are parallel, and if I make a transverse like this, it is said these two angles are alternate angle, or even we can say these two angles are alternate angle. So these two angles, these two and these two, are alternate angles. Same thing you just see. These two lines are parallel. Think it is a transverse. It is just like this. Think these two lines are parallel and this is a transverse. Then what will happen? This and this, these two will be alternate angle. So this parallel was in a horizontal form. This is in a slanted form. Think it is in a slanted form and this is a transverse. Then what will happen? This angle and this angle, these two angle will be alternate angle because of this parallel. So when it is parallel, the two angles will be alternate, and that is angle ABC. Angle ABC will be equal to angle this F, that means DFE, DFE, and both are alternate angle. So both are equal, alternate angle. And we know, children, that in two triangles, if three things are equal, then it is called congruent. And when they are congruent, the other remaining parts of the triangle also will be equal. So first of all, let us write these two triangles are congruent now. So triangle ABC is congruent to triangle, this is congruent symbol, EDF, and it became congruent by two angles and one side. You see, two angles are equal and one side. So I can write by angle, two angle and one side, by angle axiom, by angle side axiom. And when they are congruent, the other remaining parts, that means what to prove? AB is equal to FE. I can say AB will be equal to FE. So therefore, first one we can prove that AB is equal to FE by proved by CPCT. CPCT means corresponding parts of congruent triangle. So first one I have proved, first answer came. My second answer is yet to come, but my second answer also will come very easily. The second portion I am going to do in this remaining portion, what is the second thing to prove? BD is equal to CF. See, this BD is equal to CF. Now you check the diagram. BD and CF, they are not the side of these two triangles. They are little bit the extended type of line. So to prove this, we have to take the help of another way. Now you do one thing, you write BC is equal to DF, because BC is the base of triangle ABC and DF also is the base of triangle EDF. So these two can be equal. Why? Because by CPCT. They are equal by what? CPCT. CPCT. CPCT means corresponding parts of congruent triangle. So these two sides are equal. Both are base of the triangle. But from here I can prove BD is equal to CF. How? You just check it out here. BC is divided among two parts. BC. This BC is divided among two parts. That is BD plus DC. Yes or no, children? Yes. BD plus DC. And DF also is in two parts. That is DC plus CF. Now both DC same, right side, left side can be cancelled. So now what is remaining? Only BD equal to CF is remaining. Now you can see BD equal to CF you have to prove, and we could prove. So now we can say hence proved. So technical number one was very easy. Once you prove the triangles are congruent by CPCT, the two sides are equal, very easy. But second one, it was not a part of the triangle. The sides which were given to prove, they were not the complete part of the triangle, but by using this technique I could prove. So children, I hope you have understood this and you keep practicing this chapter. Thank you, children.